The Supreme Court has ordered a CBI inquiry into the suspicious death of Deputy SP Ganapathy. Now, to give you a background, Deputy Superintendent of Police MK Ganapathy allegedly committed suicide in Madikeri on July 7th. The 51-year-old Ganapathy was found hanging from the ceiling fan in a room at a lodge in Madikeri where he had gone. He left behind a suicide note adding the reason for him to take the extreme step, though the reason is not very clear. According to reports, the officer reportedly named Congress leader and Bangalore City Development Minister KJ George, his son and two senior police officers in his note.
Now, Supreme Court has asked the CBI to look into this particular MK Ganapathy's case. Now, what is your reaction to that as far as that is
concerned? See, MK Ganapathy case, as you know, it has been entrusted to CID by the High Court. And also the local magistrate also asked the police to file an FIR. Immediately, I voluntarily resigned that time because of CID or the state police will come under the state government. As a minister, I should not come in the way of the investigation.
Right.
That's why. Now I welcome the Supreme Court this judgment. Let CBI look into the matter and that let the truth come out.
So do you think that the CID investigation was a complete sham? This is what a lot of activists are claiming, and that is exactly why it was transferred to the CBI.
I will tell you one thing. The same people, for DK Ravi case also they claimed that. Mm-hmm. Then after CBI had given the report, then why these people are not reacting? Mm-hmm. Your channels also not reacted. The media is also not reacted. These NGOs and so-called opposition parties also not react. Let Supreme Court have given an action for CBI. My only request, whatever the evidence there, the thing, let them place before the CBI.
Okay.
The thing.
So who are you exactly asking the state to represent your case as far as this is concerned?
I don't know why the state. No, I represent myself.
Okay.
Why is the state will represent?
Okay.
In the Supreme Court also, I represented myself. I never involved the state for that purpose.
Now, the family, of course, has been expressing grave concerns over how the investigations have been carried out. The investigative agencies that have, in fact, been carrying out the entire probe, they did mention that this is a DYSP who, before his death, went on to state that there was a serious threat to his life, did mention political leaders, top police officials before his death. And while you have all of this being mentioned by the DYSP, then he dies in a suspicious manner. If you have state-run investigative bodies investigating the case, the family has always expressed concern over that, did mention that he is not a man who could have committed suicide and there is some sort of foul play that's involved. And now the Supreme Court, in fact, asking the CBI to investigate this matter has come as a big, big relief to the family members. Now they believe that somewhere the Central Investigative Agency could do justice to the late DYSP, and also somewhere the truth could emerge as to what really transpired in the night while he was found hanging in that lodge in Madikeri, and several other issues that will come to the fore.